A tracheostomy is a surgical opening in the windpipe or trachea. A tube is placed in the opening, thus the air goes in and out of the tube rather than through the nose, mouth, and throat. Because the nose and throat are bypassed, the air does not get filtered or humidified. This leads to mucus. Here's a picture of how the tracheostomy tube fits in the trachea. A patient would need a tracheostomy for three reasons. One, to bypass an obstructed airway. Two, to clean and remove secretions from the airway. And three, to effectively and safely deliver oxygen to the lungs. The parts of a trach include the connector, the inner and outer cannula, the neck flange, the cuff, inflation line, cuff port, lure valve, and obturator. The connector is the outermost portion of the tracheostomy tube. Ventilator tubing, a manual resuscitation bag, or a speaking valve may be connected to the connector. Here's a picture of humidified oxygen being administered through the tracheostomy tube. The neck flange has holes on either side for securing neckties. These neckties will keep the tracheostomy tube in place. The external cannula is the tube that is inserted into your windpipe. It stays there all the time and may have another part called the internal cannula that slides inside of it. The internal cannula is the tube that fits inside your outer tracheostomy tube. It is removed for cleaning or replacement. Lastly is the obturator. It is used as a guide to insert the tracheostomy tube. The inflation line is thin plastic tubing that carries air to and from the cuff. The cuff port is a small plastic balloon-like component on the end of the inflation line. The cuff port shows if the cuff is inflated. The lure valve is where the syringe is connected to inflate or deflate the cuff. The cuff or the balloon is on the end of the tracheostomy tube. When inflated, it forms a seal against the wall of your windpipe. This stops the airflow through your mouth and nose so that you breathe through the tracheostomy tube. When the cuff is inflated, the patient will be unable to speak. Here's an illustration of how the cuff works. When the cuff is inflated, the patient will only be breathing through the tracheostomy tube. When the cuff is deflated, the patient will be able to breathe through their nose, mouth, and throat. As a nurse, you need to ensure that if the balloon is inflated, the tracheostomy tube is not capped. Otherwise, the patient will have no airway.